Yeah, this is Saikishore Konda. I'm working the Intel, leading the level zero assessment efforts. Okay, so I will talk about 1AP level zero assessment today. The agenda I will talk about like the introduction about 1AP and level zero, then what are the goals of the level zero. Then I will talk SysMan architecture and what are the SysMan classes and resources. Then I will show the some flow graph diagrams for init and resources. And I'll take some example, how could you use the SysMan by any tools. Then I will end with some Python based, some CLI tool, show the example and demo and end with the questions. Okay, yeah, so the question is why 1API? Like we have like diverse workloads, which requires like different diverse architectures. Like one architecture could not solve the heavy compute workloads. So it requires, we need to have the mix of like scalar, vector, like matrix and spatial. So the future is like, it's possible that we could use mix of this combination so that it could solve the problem of the heavy compute workloads. And the, currently the problem is we don't have one simple solution where like one, whether it's a CPU or GPU, they have their own programming models, and the application developers and middleware developers, they have to modify or accordingly they need to adapt as per that. So that's why Intel came up with the solution like 1API. It's a common interface and a common like one single programming model and language where application developers and middleware can use that which will interface with all the variety of accelerators like scalar, vector, matrix and spatial. So that's why 1API is here. So okay, if you see the 1API the architecture, so it consists of the 1API product, and underneath there is a level zero software stack. So before talking about level zero, so 1API has the possible options like direct programming, or you can use the API based programming. So direct programming, like application developers who want to use the, like, you know, they use the TPC++, and they have to implement their parallel algorithms. And whereas in the API based, like it has the libraries available where like a mathematic kernel library, deep neural network, and like video processing library, all those libraries have inherent parallel programming available. And 1API product will use the level zero interface to work with the vector, matrix, and spatial combinations. So level zero interface is the lowest level user space interface, which is the which gives the fine grained control over the all the hardware accelerators, and it is divided into like three set of modules like core, tools, and system management. So core is basically for device discovery and command submission, synchronization, memory allocation, all the computer related work thing. And tools will be like for debugging, instrument programming, instrumentation, and metrics discovery. For this kind of work, tools will be there. System management is basically for managing the system for power and profile, and control the power and power and performance of the devices. Also, it will managing the devices for firmware management, like updating the firmware or like running the diagnostics or device reset. So we'll talk deep in the about system management. Okay, so what is the level zero API objectives? So basically it is a single API. It want to cover all the vector, matrix, spatial compute. It's basically low level interface, and it will be give the high performance interface to the device, and it is it has a very fine grained control over the accelerator capabilities, and it is first of all the open source, and it is standardized, and any vendor, like any third party vendor, also can use this open source code, and they can develop their own driver and for any type of accelerator, and that is welcome. And basically it is started with a GPU, you know, has influenced with the GPU architecture, but it could be expandable for scalable for other set of hardware architectures such as FPGA and other accelerators. Okay, so we'll talk about level zero SysMan goals. The basically level zero SysMan is Monitoring and controlling the power and performance of the devices, also monitoring the health of the device, and it could do device reset and update the firmware. It could monitor the RAS errors, and also it could driven event driven. If any device health changes, it could act it to the corresponding client, which is using the level 0 sysman. Also, it connect interconnect with the peer-to-peer, manage the peer-to-peer interconnection on the fabric if multiple devices are connected. So those are the set of the goals. And security prospect of the level 0 sysman, whatever the device modifications, controls, those are like imposed at the OS level. I mean, nothing like level 0 will impose. It's all imposed by the OS layer, whatever the privileges, admin privileges. Basically, you require the rootfs for some control operations on the devices, like for writing permissions. So this is a sysman, like a typical users where sysman API can be. Like in the server platform, there could be possible to run a daemon where you could control and monitor multiple GPUs connected in the server platform. And so also possible in the client products, you can end user can use the GUI based client developed using the on top of the sysman API, where it can graphically display the power, temperature, and other set of options to the user, and they can control and they can read the different things. Also, within system administrator, also they can use the using command line tool. So control will go from up and down, and all the telemetry will be only readable. So control is only writable thing. Okay, the sysman architecture diagram in generic any OS specific. So it's like generic thing. I mean, I'm not talking about any Intel or anything. It's general architecture diagram. So where level 0 sysman is part of the level 0 library, which has inherent core tools in sysman. And so this level 0 sysman will talk to the different set of KMDs, like PCI bus driver is for device reset and getting the PCI BDF information, PCI bars information, and PCI throughput information. It can use the voice specific PCI driver. And other set of KMD drivers is for accelerator and any system related function, system KMD driver, and telemetry like power, temperature, other telemetry information will be accessed through the telemetry KMD. So this is the like general typical sysman architecture diagram. And these are, like I said, Intel device drivers, but it could be any vendor. They can develop their own drivers. Okay, sysman API, like I am typically divided into different set of classes, where there is a cluster of power management and workload management and system management and reliability and hardware event and scale out. So I will talk each of the API very high level. The frequency API provides what are the available frequencies, whether it is a GPU in the system or the frequency type for any memory or like as a HBM. And it can give the control to set the min limit and max limit. Also, it can read like what are the current frequency is set to, and what is the current actual frequency set, and you want to set any frequency you would like to set from the given available frequencies list, which is provided through API. And also it has the TDP frequency, like what is the TDP max frequency which can support. And if suppose the frequency is throttled any of the reasons, because of the heating or because of the high power, so it will give the reasons why it is the frequency was throttled. So all those will be covered on part of the frequency API. And the power gives the GPU current power is consumed, and what are the peak power and what are the burst power and what are the sustainable power. Like peak power is the instantaneous power. When it is measured, it can check how much is the instantaneous power, and if it is crossing any threshold, it's always possible that we could throttle the frequency. Similarly, bus power is like average over 2 millisecond measured this power. It's called PL2. Similarly, like sustained power and around 28 millisecond, this is calculated. And user can always set limits and get limits. Also, user can have register for event. If any energy threshold, like whatever the energy consumption by GPU is crossing some certain limit, he could get notified. So that's possible in the power management. And standby is like, by default, if a device is not doing any workloads, so it can put into standby mode. But it's a costly, like if it goes to standby mode and then comes back from sleep to consume. So it's possible that for user can disable the standby mode. It can set to disable. Those options will be in the root permission level. And temperature, like it will measure the temperature across all the sensors, and it will give the max temperature within the system. So that way we could measure all the power related functionalities. And when talks about workload management, the sysman will measure the engine utilization, basically how much engines, like there are different type of engines like compute engine, copy engine, render engine, and other set of engine. When some workload is running, what is the engine utilization in a time window? It will give those information. And there is a performance factor where if you want to tune your workload only compute based or memory based. So it has a factor of 0 to 100. So if you set it to 100, you could give more energy driven to the compute oriented work. So that memory will give only 0. But if there is any memory oriented workload, we could always give the factor to 0. So that we could get throughput faster. Throughput is less from the memory oriented workloads. And scheduler, if there are multiple workloads want to submit the command queue and use the common hardware resources, there are like different scheduler modes, like scheduler slice mode and scheduler exclusive modes. Like slice mode is it will given a time in a time it will share like each time one work will be given, and then after timeout will preempt and it another task will be given. And there is a like timeout mode where you can always set timeout till what time the workload will continue, and if any high priority work will come. So after that timeout it will preempt it, and the other workload will be run. In exclusive mode, like no other workload will be run until that current workload is completed. So those kind of modes you can always use so that you can manage your workload. And memory, so this API will give what is the current free memory and what are the bandwidths and what are the read counter, write counters within the system. So it could use this information, memory of not only like HBM memory module, it could give the cache level or L1, L3, those details, memory sizes, where those inputs can be used for optimizing the for performance oriented compute workloads. And the system management, the device functional will give the like device serial number, board number, and device unique identifier. And it could also have the some set of APIs where you could say device need to reset, or if the device got wedged or device got repaired. So those information will be available within the device. And the firmware, it will give all the firmware are present within the system. It will give each firmware information and what is the firmware version. And you could also flash the specific set of firmware where you want to update the firmware. So that's possible with the sysman. And fan, PSU is like basically controlling the fan and power supply unit. Also it comes under part of the system management. Now let's talk about reliability management. The RAS are the one of the critical feature for sysman, where we could always important for if device is encountering different set of errors, like it's correctable errors or uncorrectable errors, to notify to the application. And if uncorrectable errors keep coming and device is going to in a unreliable manner, so it's always possible that a user can take action to reset the device, or user can run the diagnostics. So diagnostic is like self-test where you it can run the device function, device stability. Is the device stable, or if device need to get repair or not? So while running the diagnostic, we need to stop all the workloads. And when you run the diagnostic, it will either give no errors, or it could give that it could get abort that so that you could not use the device, you need to remove it from the cart. Or it's possible that some of the hardware repair occurred. So once repair occurred, you need to reboot to get back to the original condition. And the other thing is the event management. There are like set of events. Sometimes device reset, for example, device need to reset when you run the diagnostic. It will set the device reset event generated. Once the device reset event occurred, so application need to reset the device. Also, there are other errors like when temperature cross threshold or power cross threshold or RAS errors cross some threshold. So those will be notifying to the client. So basically, client have the register API. All the devices which are interested to listen for some particular event, they can register those events. And the listen will be at the across the system level. If let us say if multiple devices are there in this host, which are connected to host, we could listen at one point from all the devices. And scale out management is if we have connected fabric to the multiple devices, and it could possible that Sysman can enable disable particular port, and it can also check each port configuration information, what is the current and receiving transmit speed. Also, it will check the what is the remote port ID and what is the current remote fabric ID. And it's possible to bring all those information, and you can create what is the topology looks like, how all the devices are connected to the fabric. So these are the overall system classes in the Sysman API. So I will take some examples using the Python CLI, and I'll see how the field look like of those APIs. Okay, the Sysman init code example. If somebody application want to use the Sysman and they want to call those set of APIs, so what is the initialization code looks like? So they need to set an environment variable, JDS enable Sysman has to set to 1. And there's the main code where JD init initialize all the devices and all the drivers in the system. So once installation happens, then we'll call driver gate. So we'll find out how many drivers are there in the system. Based on the driver count, we allocate those many driver pointers. So for each driver, like example, if in a typical host machine, if you connect, let us say Intel GPU and NVIDIA GPU. So let us assume that NVIDIA also has supported level 0 driver. So it's possible that we could read for NVIDIA driver and Intel driver also. So for each driver, we could check like that how many devices are connected. For one driver, we could have multiple devices. So for each device, we'll get all the allocate that memory and all devices. And for each once we allocated for all devices, we'll read the properties. Currently, we are only supporting for if it is device property type is GPU, because level 0 is like generic, it could support for GPU, FPGA, and other accelerator. But right now, we have only limited to GPU. So if it is not GPU, just we return. And if it is GPU, then only we need to typecast to the Sysman device so that you will get Sysman device handle and use this Sysman device handle for the rest of the Sysman APIs to get the power, temperature, any like telemetry, or any kind of information you're looking for. So this is the example usage of the Sysman code. And let's talk about in the flow graph, how the Sysman execution diagram looks like. So when application want to use the Sysman, he will initialize through level 0 loader. So loader will load the basically level 0 library. Sysman will be inherent of the level 0 library. And this library will call iactl to get all the device cube properties. And initialize all those data structures of the each and every XPU device, and whatever the manageable resources like temperature or telemetry or strict scheduler, all the classes resources will be initialized, and it will be stored in the device and the device data structure during the installation. This is how init will take place. So once it is done, if you need to access those class resource properties, like if you want to read the what are the power properties, or if you want to read the frequency properties, anything, first we need to call the enumerate devices and get the code device handle. And code device handle, you typecast to the Sysman device handle. and then call enumerate resources. So basically you want to look like what are the modules or what are the class within the Sysman library are supported. So it will go and check all the types of the Sysman resources, and it will return those handles. So based on those handles, you can get the properties where you want to read the resource properties through Sysman library. So this way your resource execution, getting resource property can be read. Okay. Then there is one use case I want to talk about, like in a GPU, there will be like temperature is crossing like 100 degrees centigrade, and we want to check how the application can write and how can you control the by reading the temperature, how can you control. So that is a use case I just explained here. So client will call initialize the Sysman, then client will call enum temperature sensor so that it will find out what are the temperature sensors. It's go and read all the temperature modules through the telemetry KMD, and it will, whatever the sensor handles, it will return back the handle status. So once handle back, we'll call the temperature get state. So this temperature get state will read all the temperature from the sensors from the telemetry module, and it will collect all the temperature sensors from various resources and will return back what is the max temperature occurred in the device. And if we observe that there is a certain like crossing 100 degrees or something like that, we process the temperature, we could take action based on the temperature. So what I'm doing is I want to control the frequency so that it could cool down. So that I will find out like what are the frequency domains available in the system. So it will call the accelerate KMD, and it will find out what the frequency models are available, and it will return back those corresponding frequency models handles. And by using those handles, I will call like what is the current range it's set. So it will read current, what is the ranges from the driver. So it will get those frequency ranges, and we could set range to lower limit so that the temperature will be cooled down. So this is the, like one of the example use case I could cover. We could do multiple things. Okay. We have Python command line interface tool. This is basically, it is a reference implementation. It is available as an open source code. It is used to for query and control the system within the Sysman. It can print different, like simple std out print, table, CSV, XML file format. And it could support, if multiple drivers are there, we could select a driver in case of multiple drivers present in the system. So this is the example, like if you run the Python Sysman command line help, so what are the options are available? It could give the all the telemetry information, what is the temperature, what is the power here, and what are the frequency clocks available, what is, how's the engine utilization, memory and PC information, fabric ports. So whatever the Sysman features, all features are available. What are the features available? It will show everything. So I will take some few examples and demonstrate in the slides. So for example, I want to in a Gen 9, if I run this Sysman PY, what is the device list? It will show that device 0 is GPU. It is the Intel Gen 9. It is integrated GPU. And what is the UUID? And in a system where I connected like multiple discrete cards, DZ1, DZ2, or DZ1. So then it will show what are the available devices, like 4904, device 0 and device 1, like two DZ1s are connected. So that way it will show the device list information and its corresponding vendor ID and what is the name. And if you want to use the C, like what are the processor using the memory and what is the engine usage, then it will print like that. What is the device UID and what is the process ID using? What is the memory usage by that process? And what is any engine using by that process, current process. So here it is on, I didn't run any workload. So there is no engine usages here. Okay, if I run show telemetry, it could show all the temperature sensors, like what is the current temperature overall and what is the GPU temperature? What are the power domains? And what are the frequency domains available? And what are the engine groups currently? What is the activities going on? So all those information will be shown in the JD Sysman. When I run some workload in the background and then I run show utilization, I could see that the render engine activity is 100%. So because it's some workload in the background, we currently using the render engine, so that it is showing correctly. So that way JD Sysman tool could be used. And this is the collect tool. This is in the Kubernetes where OneNode have connected like multiple DigiOne cards, and this is like a graphical. This is an example of tool where the tool use the Sysman, and we could show the graphical representation of the how the GPU power consumed here. What is the GPU frequency set for different set of DigiOne cards, and what is the memory uses for on different DigiOne cards? Like that graphical way, you could show that engine utilization. Similarly, we could add more. So this is currently in development progress. So this way we could show that. So all the public repositories are here, like the specification, loader, GPU driver, and test. So you could go through. All are like open source, so anybody can go and read about it. So that's it. Any questions?